last year was the making of Les Mis, which is a wonderful musical. I've seen it several times in New York and in Atlanta. What a great musical. And we're going to do three numbers from that tonight. And some former Robins will probably know, because I think over the course of the years we probably did three or four or five or times. So enjoy three numbers from Les Mis.
Thank you. that was it. I mean, when they started singing, I'd say, we're getting a good reverb going back here in the auditorium. And then I said, oh, they're just standing up singing it. Next thing I know, there's people flooding the stage. So it did take me back.
You know, a guy like my dad can't sit still.
I think mom's going to kill him.
Yeah, if he doesn't find something to do. So.
They've been together for 30 years now?
Yeah, 30 years this year.
And he's been teaching the whole time. So I don't know what she's going to do with so much extra dad time.
Yeah, she's going to go nuts.
He's probably going to sleep in the chair and play with our dog. Yeah. So a nice, happy retirement.
It really goes nuts.
Oh, gosh, he's going to have to find something to do. Yeah. I can't imagine him not teaching.
I know.
So.
Well, you know, I'm still very busy in the music industry. I've started a new church where I've been the interim minister of music. I still teach with the South Carolina Virtual School in music and pre-class. I want to do a little bit of composing and arranging that has sort of taken the back burner because of all the demands of school.
Principal Super, would you come up, please? Somebody like Craig Duensing. For 35 years, he has poured not just his teaching time, but his love, his compassion, his interest in his students. And I'm just almost speechless when I think about how much of a difference this person made in my own life. I know I speak for everyone here, alumni, and present students alike, that you are loved and you're an amazing person. So, what we have.
Craig, I want you to know that we appreciate all that you have done. only ones who think so.
My name is Bill Nice. I'm a 1982 graduate of Richmond Northeast High School. And I would also like to thank Mr. William Craig Duensing for all he has done for me and for everyone in this audience and for all these wonderful students and alumni. But he has a better half as well. Ms. James Duensing, these flowers are dedicated for her as well. From the Richmond Northeast Alumni Association, from those up here, and for all those that she has touched as well. Thank you.
Mr. Duensing, 35 years ago, you chose me to be a charter member of the performing choir. Looking back, I see how fortunate I was. I was a freshman on our first day of class in this new high school. We went to the library for our first choir practice. We were met by a very enthusiastic youngster, scarcely older than we were at the time, and his name was Craig Duensing. We didn't have a chorus room because the building was still under construction. We didn't have a choir name, an alma mater, or school fight song, so Mr. Duensing went to work. We voted, and it was decided from that point on we would be called the Cavalier Chorale. We chose our fight song and alma mater, which you wrote. Over the past 35 years, Mr. Duensing, you touched the lives of over 1,800 choral students at Richmond Northeast High School. He has been a music director for more musicals than one can count, and has been a positive influence and role model to many, many more during your tenure at Richmond Northeast High School. So tonight, in honor of your 35 years and pending retirement, we, the choir alumni, and your students past and present have come together to honor you. We, your opus, give you this gift as a token of our love, appreciation, and gratitude.
we doubled up on the flowers tonight inadvertently. And so we're going to present these to you to match your boutonniere. God bless you for all you've done, Mr. Duensing.
Mr. Duensing is a beloved teacher, loved by his students, and if anybody deserves anything like this, it's him.
You know, it's different to like music. Like, most people like music.
Yeah.
But this is different to have a passion for music. Like, both Beck and I had a little musical talent, but neither of us had the passion.
No. Not to his degree. No. Not at all.
Not to where it's just an all-consuming passion. But,
yeah.
You know, that doesn't come along. You know, Dad could have done anything he wanted to, but he chose to do music in schools like this, and I think anyone who's ever stepped through his class can say that, you know, they really benefited from just being in his class.
It's not just the music that he taught us about. It was about just having character and, you know, loving what you do no matter what. He's just always been there. He's a strong person, and he's always ready to lead you in the right direction. So,
emotional, I think I've been prepared for this. I've known for about 3 or 4 months that I was going to be retiring. So it was an exciting time. The emotions will probably hit a little later, but the excitement of seeing everybody and just being a part of their lives has been incredible tonight.
Well, some people think he's going to cry.